Hi, this is Anubhav and welcome to our channel World Gang. And today we are going to review on the movie Shubh Mangal Zyada Savdhan. After Supreme Court of India took a historic decision of striking down Section 377 of Indian Constitution on September 2018, where consensual same-sex relationship was considered unconstitutional. But it is the first of many steps taken to provide an identity for homosexuality status in India. Shubh Mangal Zyada Savdhan has taken a leaf out of the page to provide a comical take on the topic, adding a family entertaining quotient. After overcoming erectile dysfunction in the first installment, Ayushman Khurrana takes up his role as Karthik, this time as a gay lover to his friend Aman, played by TVF's beloved Jitu Bhaiya or Jitendra Kumar. The film deals with how their relationship wins in the face of circumstances posed by Aman's conservative yet crazy family and how they are unaffected what the world views them. Acting-wise, Ayushman is on a sublime form. He does not shy away from doing his best, wearing Shaktiman-clad suits to make a dramatic entry in most scenes where he does not keep up for his love towards Aman. Jitendra has also delivered well in sync with Ayushman Khurrana, who goes against his father's wishes to marry a girl. He is convincing with his one-liners.
Karthik ko jab maine pehli baar dekha tha na, mummy meri badi ho gayi thi. Putliyan aankhon ki putliyan badi ho gayi thi.
Gajraj Rao as a scientist Shankar Tripathi, who creates and sells his unique kala gobi in his hometown, has been hilarious as a conservative father. Manu Rishi Chaddha as his brother Chaman Tripathi, Neena Gupta as Sunaina Tripathi, Sunita as Champa Tripathi, Manvi as a marble ball, Gogol, have a striking presence who make the Tripathi family a crazier asset to be handled, each one on its own having a problem to deal. Writer-director Hitesh Kevalya did a splendid job in wisecracking audience with his witty writing, thus ensured that story remains the driving force of the movie. It is brilliant in the first half. What we failed, it did take too many issues to bind it in its storytelling, like Kusum's character wanting to marry her lover who's of lower caste, incomplete love of Tripathi couple, unfulfilled dreams of female characters where they regret to have not achieved as they have desired. Second half slowed down its pace of screenplaying. The build-up towards the climax, citing Section 377 getting struck down, should have been executed better. Being 2 hours long, it would be worth your money to see something entertaining provided on a topic which has been considered regressive in Indian society at present. But it also enables you to think that love knows no wrath for beings with soul, irrespective of what you are.